Good morning. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let's join together and praise his name. We welcome you this morning. If you'll stand for the reading, the word, 1 Peter, chapter 1 and verse 3. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy has he given us new birth into the living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Not a dead hope, but a living hope. You know, a lot of folks says, well, with I heard that for the election that America had no hope. I said, well, they don't know Jesus Christ then. Because in a hopeless situation, there is hope when you have hope in Jesus Christ. So bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Let us worship him and praise him together. Join with me and let's thank him for being in his house with us this morning. Father, I'm so thankful, Lord, that you're in your house. Lord, with others, precious believers this morning. Lord, for we have that living hope, that hope that's in Christ Jesus. Not a dead hope, but a living hope. And I bless your name. And Lord, I've come together to worship you and to bless your name with others. Lord, accept our praise as we praise you together and bless you together. Amen, amen. Turn and shake somebody's hand next to you and say, let's bless the Lord together.
At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burning of my heart rolled away, it was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Must Jesus bear the cross alone, and all the world will free. No, there's a cross for everyone, and there's a cross for me. Oh, at the cross where I first saw the light, and the burning of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. Oh, at the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Alas, and did my Savior bleed?
can be free. We can be whole. I'm thankful for the blood this morning. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, It's time.
Let's sing it one more time this morning.
He holds every strand to the highest mountain.
Oh,
let it roll to the lowest valley. From day to day,
hey, how
it will never move. His power.
Oh, would you give the Lord a hand clap of praise for that this morning? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I believe we can do a better job than that this morning. Oh, we're thankful for the blood of the Lamb today. Thankful, Lord, that He washes away our sin. Makes us new, makes us clean. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord this morning. I have felt the sweet presence of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Thankful that He is with us on a Sunday morning. So thankful for what God is doing amongst us, in our midst, and in your families. Amen. It's a delight today for us to have with us Joyce Igo and Stephen, her grandson Stephen, and they were been with us the last couple of years, and I missed them last year. I was on regional bishop assignment last time they were with us, but I'm glad I get to be with them, and we're going to turn this service over to them. They're going to sing a few songs and testify in between, and then we'll come back and take care of stuff that we need to take care of, and I'm just looking forward to what God has for us this morning. Amen. Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord? Amen. Would you welcome Sister Joyce and Brother Stephen as they come to minister to you this morning?
I'm going to be very quick. Everyone knows what song I'm going for. Slap them down and just kind of look at it.
And he came over and he said, "Is this yours?" And he said, "Yeah." So we read the water today. And so I actually got some witness to him because of that. And you know, what's really fascinating is that I got to tell him about, you know, how Muslims do not realize what kind of power we Christians have in Christ Jesus. They never knew that the disciples, when the Holy Spirit and the disciples, even Peter, shadowed they were good people. And they had no idea. And so I was able to witness to them for the miracles I've seen. And how it's not Allah, it's Jesus.
Hey.
And you know, that's good.
Amazing.
Okay,
that's good. Well, I think there's titles on this, but there you go.
You know, now you set yourself up for that one. I gotta tell you the story now. The reason she said that is because, you know, unfortunately, we're working on writing our own songs, so whatever right now, we're coming to another big week. And she can't even know the names of these songs.
I don't know, that's why.
Now, we were at the church, and we were doing good, and what songs we're going to write, have to write, and she just looks at it and happens to play that song about Jesus.
Yeah.
I said, "Only one that we do. All the songs about Jesus."
I asked him to say that.
Yeah.
Don't help me. Say,
it's hard.
Oh, my God.
We never got that one.
I can't remember how to go. Something I've been going to go. That's all. I don't know. Holy Spirit. I know I'm saved. That's it.
Amen.
I know I'm filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I know.
and he calls it an opportunity. So I had an opportunity back then. I was able to do one mission trip, unfortunately, and I went to Peru. It was an awesome trip. I had a 3-day ladies conference, and ladies walked all week to get in, out of the jungles to get there to the church. And then we had to walk another week home. And it's amazing that I told him last night, it just really blows me away how people in these countries can walk all week to get to church. And we've got people in the United States of America can't get across the street.
Right.
And I always feel a little bit about that. But we were speaking in the Holy Spirit for the 3-day conference, and at least 12 of the ladies received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And I was thrilled over that. We saw some come from other parts. It was just an awesome time. And I want to let know that I think we'll go back in the future. Unfortunately, I brought something back with me that I didn't need to bring back. And by the end of April, I was in a terrible state. I had no rest night or day. It felt like somebody sticking needles in my eye 24/7. The pain was excruciating. And by the time I got to the doctor, my whole eye was, couldn't even see it. I was just covered. And when I found out what was going on, apparently I had contacted a flesh-eating bacteria in the room. And as a result, it made a hole in the cornea. And they're going to have to have a cornea transplant. But I know I should really be thankful, Pastor Ricky, that people will donate parts of their body to people after they leave it. But Sister Ricky, it was just something about having some vegetables this morning in my eye. It suited me too well. And smile here, so I know. Tell them what you said, Mr.
I said, look at this, Mom. When the Bible says that the dead in Christ will rise first, right? Well, your point is going to be good.
I love that. Anyway, so we did that, and I was so weak, and he had his foot for Bob, and he was supposed to say for him. And then they told me I had a cataract on the city, right? And the accident is captured now. But you know, with my girl, and put about new pieces. And then I was down again for the count. And but thank God, in October, I had my last surgery on the 3. And they were able to clean out. They said that it was a very difficult bacteria to kill, but it was dead. Hallelujah. It ate part of the retina. I don't want to get this right, but Stephen's always had to tell me how much. I think when I woke up or something, that's all right. This song. phenomenal, supernatural, strength, full of true faith.